A very warm welcome to Mallorca, one of the most favorite, if not the most favorite, holiday destination for Germans. It's the largest of all Balearic Islands and a part of Spain. In fact, it's so popular as a tourist destination that on 12th March, when the German government said Mallorca does not qualify as a risk area for coronavirus, Eurowings claimed that almost all its flights from Germany to Mallorca were sold out in a matter of few hours. Let's have a look how this island is doing in these post-COVID times and what all you can enjoy here as a tourist. Let's go. That right there is the Cathedral of Palma, a really massive cathedral lying right on the shoreline. It's 44 meters tall and includes one of the largest rose glasses in the world. Palma is the capital city of Mallorca. It's a really pretty city and one of the most bike-friendly cities that I've ever seen. I would definitely recommend you to rent a bike here and just look at this. Go around on the coastline and in the old city on a bike. There's a whole lot of activities that you can enjoy on this Mallorca island. For example, scuba diving. But unfortunately, the scuba diving shops are closed because of the COVID restrictions. You can also do cliff jumping. But unfortunately, the water is too cold for that. So I'm doing something that can be done in almost any kind of weather, any kind of restriction. It's hiking and e-biking up the mountain. I rented this fantastic e-bike for around 25 euros a day, and my plan is to go from all the way from Palma to Valldemossa. It's a very famous tourist town, approximately 20 to 30 kilometers away. So it's said that it's supposedly is going to take me around 2 hours of biking there, but the slope of this hill is quite a bit actually, so it might take me around an hour longer. There are some fresh oranges on this tree, and over there there's some other fruit also, but unfortunately I can't take this because it's a private property of someone. Be careful here, looks like it's easy to ignite fire, bushfires in this area. What a long and straight road. I'm with the cars here on this road. And it looks like I'm here in Valldemossa now. I can already see a few restaurants here. So first of all, let me fill my stomach up. I'm very hungry. This is the famous village of Valldemossa, a village full of attractive buildings, outstanding beauty here. It's also a UNESCO World Heritage Site, but currently it's so empty that it's unbelievable. Almost every shop, every restaurant is closed here, and there are hardly any people as you can see. It took me around 3 hours to get here by cycle from Palma, but I guess the way back would be quite easy because it's all downhill from here. I'm estimating around 1.5 hours to reach back. Just like in Lisbon, there are multiple observation decks throughout the whole of Palma which offer some scenic views of the city. They are called miradors. Right now I'm standing at one of these miradors. This one is specifically called Mirador Baluar del Príncep. And look at the view here. I can see the beachfront and I can see the sunset happening behind me. And also the cathedral, if you look over there. Right next to the majestic building of art and contemporary museum over there, there's a very nice park here, which is called Parc de Sa Feixina. And there's an interesting sundial over here, a very historical sundial which shows the current time. I'll show you. Look at this natural watch right here. Based on the shadow of the sun, it's telling us the current time right now. It's almost 12 p.m. and it's pretty accurate. And this chart over here shows what time of the year this is, and it's 19th March today. So 21st March is almost accurate also. This very pleasant cycling track runs along the whole coastline of Palma. I showed you this the other day, which had the beach next to it. However, this area is right next to the dock. And right over there is where I'm planning to go right now. The famous castle, which is called Castel de Bever. So let's go cycling once again. So I have already entered Bosque de Bever. It's a large patch of forest land surrounding the castle. Very steep here. If you are looking to come here by walking or on a cycle, which is not an e-bike, be ready for a small hike. A 4 euro entry ticket to get up the castle, but unfortunately it seems like it's closed also. Even though on Google it said it's open and on the website it said it's open. So unfortunately I can't go in. However, I can still enjoy the architecture from the outside. Okay, well, I was wrong about this being closed because it's actually open, but the entry is completely free. That's why the ticket counter was closed, and surprisingly, there is no one here except me. There is also a museum inside this castle which describes the long and detailed history of the Palma city and the Mallorca island. Perhaps the most unique thing about this castle is its circular shape. It's one of the few round castles in the whole of Europe. It was built in the early 14th century, initially used as a royal residence, but at some point of time during the World War II, it was also used as a prison. And from this castle, not only can you enjoy the greenery around it or the mountains in the background, but also you can have a view of the whole Palma city right here and the blue sea next to it. I'm here on this beach, Santa Ponsa, which is rather empty. There's not many tourists here. In fact, there are almost no tourists here. So let's ask some people here and see how the situation has been going in Mallorca in the past 1 year and what is the outlook in the next 1 year. Bhagwan Singh here works on the beach and Anmol works in a restaurant here. I would just like to ask you two that how has it been in the last 1 year?
Well, last year was very tough for us, even though tourists and, you know, the Mallorca depends on the tourist sector. It's a tourist sector. Well, you can see the beach is also empty. The restaurant shops are also closed. It's a very tough year for us.
How has the government been helping you regarding this situation?
Well, government is providing us a lot of aids to the local shops and to the for example for the rent, for the food elements.
But do you expect that in the coming months will the situation improve as the tourism increases?
I think we have a lot of positive news. I think by the end of May we'll be getting a lot of tourists.
So by end of May you expect the tourism to start becoming normal again?
Yeah, I think so, but we'll see what happens.
Is this emptiness normal here in at this time of the year, or is it because
it just
of
happened
corona?
Last year when the COVID arrives.
Okay.
It's really full of people, it's full of tourists. Well, you can see in this area, like this is the tourist area, due to the, there is no tourist, there are not so much shop open, but you can see in Palma there's a little bit shop open because it's the local area.
So outside of Palma, most of the shops and businesses are still closed because the amount of tourists are still not as much here. In general, Palma is known for its beautiful beaches. There are long stretches of sand to walk on and crystal clear waters. Many water sports to do like sailing, flyboarding, and I'm sure you won't miss it when you come here in the summertime. In the rest of the Mallorca island, Drac Caves are another popular tourist attraction, which once again were not open when I was there. But the surprising thing was there was a lot to do and a lot to see even in these times. I hope you enjoyed this short overview of Majorca Island. If you found it informative, do subscribe to the DW Travel channel for more such videos. See you next time.